previously on the Novibia channel.
Nova's got lovely toes. I'll tell you now. Do you want me to describe it so you can draw them?
And coming up...
Do you know, I've never liked you.
I find you very rude.
The Novimpia Chanel is made possible by our gorgeous patrons who get access to the most unappealing crap you'll find anywhere on the whole internet.
Cue the snafu!
Good evening and welcome to the first of the spooky season Novimpia videos. I have been asked to come here today by a certain South African mystic maven who has been absent for quite a while. I don't know what that's been about, but a lot of people have been asking where she's been.
And hello Nora. How are you doing, darling? I have not seen you in a little minute just now.
That's a bit clammy, isn't it?
Like, what are you doing? We don't know each other.
How did you do that?
Don't know each other that well. I came down just now in my delivery pod system. Right. Patent pending on that one, by the way. I know what you're like. Don't take notes.
I'm going to put your phone in airplane mode.
There's nothing coming through on... This isn't even my telephone, so don't get cheeky with me. You Mardi car. Well, why don't I introduce myself just now? My name
I've
is...
I've already introduced you, but
it's
okay.
It's Dr. Jenks, and I am world-renowned mystic, sometimes under the pseudonym Mistress Raven. And today I thought it would be quite entertaining for this, the spooky season of October, to read Nora her star chart that I have designed through my own app. I have developed an app. I have developed a star chart app. And by the way, I must just put it out there just now. I was not aware of this until just last night that there is some sort of missing person campaign for me.
Oh, yes.
People think I have gone missing.
Well, where have you been?
Well, I will tell you, I have been giving seminars in Portugal.
On Portugal?
Yes, I have been on a fashion retreat with my business partner, Nikki Hambleton-Jones. And I have been giving seminars on how to best use tartan.
Okay.
How to up your tartan game. And I think you should really take the lesson.
So we gave up on the... Was it sailing lessons? What was it? You were doing something on the water.
It was parasending.
Parasending.
Or that thing where you go on a sort of small yacht and you hold the side of it. What's that? Parasailing.
I think that was... you were teaching it.
No, I wasn't teaching it. I ran the lockers. But the whole affair got closed down. There was something... There's something very silly about somebody lost all of her money in her purse. And I don't know what that was about. So don't come after me. But needless to say, I cannot set foot in New Zealand again.
Okay.
Nova, I'd like you just now... The app is called Data's Star Chart App. And I've opened it just now. And it's funny because even though I developed this app myself with a small team, but mostly myself, I don't know how to add you as a friend on the app to read your star guide stars. That's not even my telephone, so I must not be blamed for these things. I don't want to be rude, Nora, but your set does smell a bit woofy. Like windy plop poo poo.
Yes, it does.
Have you been caught short?
So I've put in, I was born on the 13th of September, 1992 at 11:45 p.m. So nearly the 14th of September.
I appreciate that you are trying to sort of keep this air of youth about yourself. But would you like to perhaps talk to me about your real date of birth? The real authentic... Because this is not going to work as you lie to me.
It's the 13th of September,
this is not good. Don't raise your voice. Don't raise your voice to me, you harlot. 1992. Well, shall we just split it down the middle and say 87?
No.
Well, I can't be giving you an accurate reading if you won't give me your year of birth.
That is my year of birth.
Is it?
Yes.
Good lord.
Listen, I am due a little.
Have you had a hard
laugh,
the doctors? You've had a hard laugh.
Sometimes I feel like it.
Do you eat your fruit and vegetables, Nora?
Yes.
Do you get your...
I'm vegetarian.
Vital nutrients.
I only eat fruit and vegetables.
Oh, perhaps you should eat some meat. That's why you look a bit sag. It's all very well and good being that, you know, hug the trees, etc. But you might want to get a bit piece of car.
Car?
A piece of car, or perhaps a biltong. Don't make fun of my voice. That's not nice, is it? Now, here is Nora's star chart here. And I can see a lot here. There's a lot on here. It's sort of a table, isn't it? It's sort of a table and, you know, your ascendant. Your ascendant in Taurus, the bull.
What's that mean?
It means that you're getting right up my bull's ass. That's exactly what that means. All of the planets are there, aren't they?
Well, yes.
There's planets just here in this in this table.
That's what a birth chart has.
And on the 11th hour, your moon is in Aries. It basically, Aries means that you are a fairy, which is quite right. Because you're a bit light in your life, aren't you? Based on this, boys aren't supposed to wear bows in their hair. Those are limited to girls and small dogs. The star chart is telling me that you need to get a grip.
Okay.
Take that, stupid.
That's really nice.
How long have you owned that for?
A while.
About 10 years, I'd say, based on the sort of muck and dust on it. So perhaps you want to... This is telling me you need to buy new accessories. Open the purse strings a bit. Cheap. Open the purse strings. Yes. Sorry. Sun in Virgo. So you are a Virgo.
Yes.
My app, Star Chart app, told you that is that.
I mean, I already knew I was a Virgo.
I don't think you knew. If you are a Virgo, does that mean that you're not very lucky in love?
No, have you not ever?
You've
that.
Never been touched.
That's not what that means.
Or would you like to be touched?
Not by you.
I'm not offering. Absolutely not.
But it sounded like you were.
I couldn't possibly. Well, cheat on my current, very, very current on-off lover, Rafe. I could not cheat on him. If you're going to cheat, you would probably cheat with something a little higher, wouldn't you? Something a little higher.
I'm a catch.
Higher up the ladder. Catch of the day.
Yeah.
You trout.
Catch of your day.
You trout.
That wasn't very nice.
Nora, it seems to me that the last time you had me on, you were a little bit more gracious and treated me with some bloody respect.
Well, I feel like we've learned a lot more about you since.
What have you learned? Precisely.
Just what to expect.
No, you don't. Not at all. So you are a lonely Virgo. Bit of a loser.
Not lonely.
You can't get touched in the bed.
That's not what that means.
The sun determines your ego, identity, and role in life.
Okay.
I've never heard such rubbish.
It's your app.
I've never heard such rubbish. I don't believe I'd type that in. My team is very expensive and large, so I don't know who's doing all the grunt work. I'll download this app.
Well, you made me do it.
Sounds like shit. It's the core of who you are, and it's the sign you're most likely to already know.
What?
I don't understand it. The sun in Virgo means you are particularly smart. I need to get onto RT. This must be broken.
I'm very smart.
I don't understand. Are you?
Yes.
What's your IQ?
I don't
14?
Know.
14? Bit higher? Responsible? Well, I think that is quite... I've heard things about you. I've heard that on a holiday vacation, you're a nightmare. You're far, far too organised.
But I make sure that everybody is organised.
But I think, you know, if perhaps people are trying to relax on vacation...
Well, they can't relax if they don't know...
If
they don't know how to check into the hotel,
you know,
what time the flight is,
no,
where is dinner, they can't relax.
I think that if somebody...
I allow people to relax.
Wants to just get away for 5 minutes for a massage with a happy ending. You should perhaps just allow that and not be so, no, we're going to look at this old vase in a museum. That's very boring. People, you know, people say they like to do those things. They don't really like to. They want the happy ending. Let's recap so far. What have you got from this so far?
A happy ending.
No, I'm not giving you that. I'm not giving you that. And don't go after Rafe.
Stop flirting with me.
Rafe
then.
Won't give you one either. He's a dirty bastard. He's absolutely Randy in the pants. You are thorough, meticulous, and intentional in everything you do. That was intentional.
That sounds correct.
That was all intentional, was it? Have you got a pantyhose? You haven't got pantyhose on. It's in your fourth house, meaning they feel the need to distinguish themselves from others through their home.
What?
You have distinguished yourself from others with this. I can't imagine many people would like to live here.
My other half, Olympia, did half of this.
I don't understand why she's never here when I come to visit you. I don't understand that.
I think she's scared of you.
I don't think... Why would anyone be scared of me? I'm delightful. I'm delightful and frothy and not a criminal. Shut your pie. Shut your pie just now. I shall have to have an arranged meeting with your other half. Is she as diabolical as you are?
You could say that.
Oh, she sounds like a pig. Your moon is in Aries. Now look at this now.
That was the one that made me a fairy, you
said. Drews, perhaps you'll shut up and let me finish. The moon rules your emotions, moods, and feelings just now. This is likely the sign you most think of yourself as. Emotional, state, moody, and a bit mardy, it says here.
Don't
think it does.
It reflects your personality when you're alone, dreadfully alone, deeply uncomfortable, and also dreadfully alone. Your moon is in Aries, meaning the emotional self is independent, energetic, enthusiastic, and pathetic. You have a tendency to feel inadequate. Oh, I'm so sorry about that. That's what it says. I've not written that. I divine it from above. And then I get some grunt, some poor person at IT does it for me. I don't write this myself. I simply speak it out into the world and some dickhead writes it down. You have a tendency to overcompensate because failure is very, very likely.
Yeah. That sounds right.
What have you failed in most recently?
Like any competitive game, anything, I've failed.
But surely with your vastly small group of friends, you'd probably only be able to play solitaire. And to be perfectly frank, Nora, I think I'm just inside your mind's eye.
What?
Am I even here?
Yes, because your very warm hand is on my thigh.
Have you not
right
just
now.
Made me up, Nora, as a mechanism to get you through your cold, lonely days?
Don't gaslight me.
That's what the app is saying to you, Nora. Ascendant in Taurus. Now, this is where it gets even worse. Your ascendant is the mask you present to people. Do you understand?
Okay.
Mask. It can be seen in your personal style and how you come off to people when you first meet. Some say it becomes less relevant as you get older. Right. That's quite right, because you do put on a mask and a persona, don't you?
Well, I am right now.
Because you don't want people to know who you really are. You hide behind all of this cotton candy nightmare. I think you hide behind it because you are desperate to be touched.
You're very touchy-feely tonight. I think you're desperate to touch me.
Would you like me to tell you the truth about Rafe?
Sure.
If we're going to do this, Nora, I feel like we're going to do it, aren't we?
I think it's not good.
My very, very on-off current lover is more of an off.
I had suspected.
Non-current lover. Because he has gone off with Constance from the African shop, who still owes me some fucking banana bread. She did not even have the nerve. She took my man and did not leave me with any banana bread, not even the recipe for me to create it myself, which I just think is absolute. I have not done anything to her.
Are you sure?
I killed her sister.
Okay.
How was I to know she could not breathe underwater?
Can you breathe underwater?
Yes, out of my gills. I don't... You are stubborn. I believe that's right. Stubborn.
Sure.
Stubborn. Stubborn.
Okay, yeah.
Deliberate and maternal.
No.
Very, very maternal.
No, not at all.
I saw a really sort of scrawny, straggly animal out there, which was smelly and not very attractive. But is that a pet, perhaps, you own?
It doesn't sound like any
pet. It was a little tiny cat, but it really was very scruffy. I would not have that in my house.
It doesn't sound like any of our cats.
It looks like there was a cat. I saw a cat upstairs. Little sort of black and white little thing. She was a bit of a bitch. Smelled
that
not great.
That sounds like Janice Pepper.
Oh, you do own that?
Yes.
Gosh.
She doesn't look scruffy.
Did you buy her on sale? She needs a good wash. You should run her through the dishwasher.
No, she's very good.
Run her through the dishwasher. No. She looks estate.
No, she doesn't. She
needs
lovely.
To put some whiskers on it. There was no...
She does.
No, she must have just pulled them out. She'd done something to them. My God knows what she's done.
What have you done to my cat?
I haven't done anything to it.
What have you done to my cat?
Just don't look inside my purse. Because that's an invasion of privacy, and I don't think you should do that. If it meows and moves, then that's just a feature of my meowing, moving purse. Your Mercury in Virgo. That's what you are.
What does that mean?
That's what you are. Mercury is in Virgo, meaning intellect is analytical, precise, diligent, and barely there. Unbiased sense of logic can make them seem a bit clinical. You're very dreadfully biased.
So it's just an unbiased.
Biased. Unbiased. That's what I mean. Yes, no, that's wrong. That's wrong. Because you are biased.
To what?
Anything that is not from South Korea, apparently. Don't want to go to the Netherlands because I don't know where it is. And apparently you don't like it and wish it wasn't there because it's not South
Korea. People watching our videos.
Well, I have to know what I'm getting myself into. Oh, okay. I must say, it's really a bad show over there. There's some terrible shite you put out into the world.
Yeah.
I cannot believe you tried. That's my opinion. What was that? What was that's my opinion?
We don't talk about that.
Did you know that nobody watched it? Are you aware of that? Nobody watched that. That's my opinion. If you have an opinion in the forest, but nobody is there to listen to it, did the opinion exist?
Who knows?
If you had an opinion in a vast woodland, why did nobody watch your show on YouTube? Why? Nobody even clicked on it. It was about 2 o'clock in the morning. I couldn't stop crying with laughter. I thought, God, she's a child. God loves a child. You have a tendency to be nitpicky and point out what's wrong rather than what's right.
I don't think that's true.
My glasses are slipping. And I see that as a very bad omen. Yes, these were very, very expensive. They're Christian Dior. You are cautious and in... No, that says curious. Read. Can you read properly, please? Curious about and inclined to analyse how to take care of people.
What?
Do you shove your nose in where it doesn't belong? Tell people how to live their life? I think that must be accurate.
No.
You are the sort to do that just now. You get your oar in, you shove it in and you say, you know what? I'm going to give you my opinion. That's my opinion. Your penis is in Libra.
That doesn't sound correct.
Yes, it does. The planet penis determines how
Venus.
How and what you love and the qualities you're attracted to. So your Venus is in Libra, meaning you are attracted to ladies who are attracted to other ladies. Don't understand me just now.
I'm not sure that's correct.
Libra. Ladies who love ladies. I don't have anything against that. I just want you to know. I'd like your audience to know that, you know, you might be the owner of a fanny and also appreciate the sexual company of somebody who has a fanny. I don't mind what you do in the bedroom. Just don't shove it in my face.
Okay. there it is.
Live your life if you are a Libra. You can be a bit self-obsessed. Shit. Shit.
Doesn't say that.
Self-obsessed. You may have trouble being realistic or loyal.
This is a lot of different things all at once.
You can't be loyal. Fuck. Do you cheat? Do you step outside the marriage?
Sometimes, on occasion.
Who would that be with?
I don't know until it happens.
Another lady who loves ladies. Are you one of those?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Let's be quite frank, Nora. If I ask you if you're a Libra and you said I'd rather not talk about it, the answer's yes.
I'm not sure. I think...
Of course it is!
I don't think you know what a Libra is.
I don't know. I'm not up to scratch with all of the lingo and all of that business. Having a box lunch at the Y. All of that business. I don't know how you would describe it.
Lesbian.
In my day, that would have given you a swift clip round the ear if you said something like that. So disgraceful. Mars is the planet of aggression. Now, are you aggressive?
No.
Aggressive? Aggressively dull.
Something that depends like that? On who you ask.
It determines... No, it wasn't a question. It determines how you assert yourself, take action, and the energy that surrounds you, particularly in your sex life.
Aggressively dull sex life.
Good Lord, let's unpack that.
Is that what you're saying?
Is that what you're saying? How bad is it? Things have gotten really bad. Do you require marital sex aids that use batteries?
Well, this is why I step out of the marriage on
things
occasion.
Things that plug in? Things that strap on?
No comment.
What's your sex life like?
Very diverse.
That sounds disgusting. That sounds absolutely revolting. Diverse. Not tender, romantic, diverse. I bet you've got all sorts of smut. Does she make you wear an apron that's made of rubber?
Come on, carry on now.
That are wipeable. You're a slut, aren't you? You're a smut slut.
A smut slut?
In the butt.
No, it's boring. I'm going to move on. I don't want to read that. That's shit.
Now, what are you doing? I'm doing this just now. I'd like to know what the fuck you think you're playing at. Why don't we take a look at your romantic compatibility with your partner? Your partner, whose name, what was her name? I didn't quite catch.
Olympia.
Oh, that's a strange, that's a sort of very old-fashioned. Is she quite old-fashioned?
Yeah.
Where does she come? Does she come from a house that sort of smells a bit like celery? One of those sorts.
Yeah.
You know, you walk in, you're like, Christ. Like a little light Febreze would not go missing here.
That's her.
It says here that there is a 90% chance that she would crush you if she were to roll over on top of you in the bedroom.
Yeah.
I don't know much about her, but is she large?
She's about the same size as you.
I do not like the way you answered that question. You are a cheeky, cheeky car. If she's the same size as me, Nora, she is svelte. Very, very svelte. Dreadfully fucking svelte.
So svelte means, like,
slim.
Could thin. Potentially get into a sample size.
Of a tent?
Nora, I've never... Do you know, I've never liked you. I'm going to say it. I'm going to say it just now. I've never liked you. There's some things that a lady doesn't want to hear. Look, I'm crying now, just out of my eye hole. I'm crying a tear just here, just now. I'm not coming back here. I'm not coming back.
Please don't.
No, I won't. It says here that the chances that you might wed in marital bliss. There's a percentage here of a chance where you might be wed in marital bliss. Would you like to know the percentage?
Sure.
2%. It says here, oh, she is fucked. Give Christ. I think, Nora, what we have learned here is that I should have to speak to someone about this app because there was not anything in there positive, was there? Nothing nice about you.
No,
why don't you allow me to end this experience with some positive compliments of yourself?
Sounds dangerous.
They were not featured in the app.
Okay, so...
Which I will fix that.
Okay.
Because I think people will be very upset and delete the app and I'd like them to keep it for a very long time.
Okay.
Because I desperately need some money. Compliments for you, Nora, are that I think you are the sort of person that really just goes for it and does what they love regardless of anything else. Doesn't matter if you can't do it. Doesn't matter if there's not much in the way of skill. You say, bugger that and to hell with it. I enjoy it, so I'm going to go and have fun and do it. Which I think is dreadfully, dreadfully admirable. On your part. So I'd like to congratulate you on really having a great lust and vigour for life.
Thank you.
And I think I speak for everyone when I say that we'd all love a second season of That's My Opinion. Just now.
That's not happening.
Oh, I think you should think about it. Your solo venture.
That's happening.
Well, you had a real presence on there, didn't you?
I thought you told me that one of the videos had 17 views.
And I was 16 of them. I can't give you all the bloody views, can I? Listen, Nora, thank you for allowing me to return today.
Why are you here?
I will finish a sentence before you interrupt. Do you understand?
Well, it's my channel.
Do you understand? Well, as far as I understand it, it's the other birds.
No.
I've basically just come back here to let everyone know that I am still alive. I know people were wondering what had happened. And to sort of deliver some very hard and sad home truths to Nora in her star chart. And to just tell her to keep going. Just keep going, darling. I think you've got this.
Very touchy-feely again.
You've got it in the bag. I would like everyone to go to my website, datajenks.org.
Co.za.
Yes. And I would like everyone to sign up to receive newsletters to inform you about my latest business venture, which is I'm going to be opening a cat museum, whereby you might come by and have a look at all the cats. And you may pet them.
Museum.
You may pet them and say hello and spend the afternoon with one of the cats. At the moment, we've only got one. And then you may leave a large monetary deposit and then go home. Thank you, Jasna.
Subscribe. She'll be gone next week. And Olympia will be back.
Well,
so subscribe.
I might stick around.
So you can see that. We also have a Patreon where you can get exclusive content. Olympia has a podcast. We actually make
money
on
this. What on earth does
website.
She talk about? What on earth would she have to talk about? What does she talk
All
about?
All kinds of rubbish.
Oh, right. Well, I mean, I will give it a listen, but I will give it precisely 3.5 minutes. And if I have not had my tonsils tickled, then I shall turn it off.
Well, the link for that is appearing right now.
How's it?
What you gonna do?
Okay, social media is in the description box below. Please don't follow any link that she posts. And happy Halloween. We'll be back next week with more spooky goodness.
If you receive an email from me that says, you know, this might be a virus, I promise you it's not a virus. And if something pops up and it says, oh my God, what are the 3 digits on the back of your credit card? Just pop it in. No. Pop it in. And don't worry about the rest of it.
If you look on that laptop there, Olympia's got a list of some birthday wishes we are to give to some of our
patrons. Is that just there, Jasna? Well, I would like to say happy birthday to you, Jasna, for the 5th of October, Cookie Cream Pie.
Happy birthday, Cookie.
And for October 7th, Marcel.
Happy birthday, Marcel.
Happy birthday to you two delightful, lovely people. You've lost your mind signing up to this. You've lost your mind. Well, I'm going to go now. And okay. I will be lurking.
I love that purse.
I will be lurking.
I love the contents of that purse.
And I'm going to... Just give me a moment here. Just give me a moment here. How's it? Whoa, won't give you my voice. And a hello, how are you doing to Nora's brand new patrons? Zach and Brandon, Monteith, Larson B, Oddie, Mary Chapman, Sam Stephen, and Alex in the Auger. Hello.
How does she do that?
I'm still here, Nora. God, you've got so much shit in your attic.
Join the Patron, we'll do a shot of Patron.